This is a little different than what I normally play on this channel, but I have been a fan of the Nancy Drew games for a very long time. They've always been well-done games, and this is the latest one that just came out, Midnight in Salem. So I figured I'd record it. I am not certain I will upload it. It is different kind of content than my channel and whatnot, but we'll see. I might end up uploading it between the latest episode or latest game that I played of Assassin's Creed and the next one, just to mix things up a little and have that kind of out there. So this will kind of go up sometime in mid-January, but it's early December right now that I'm recording this. So let's just hop in. Ooh. Let's give it a shot. If I have to change difficulty later, I will, or I have a guide, so.
Dear Ned, Austria has been wonderful so far. Dad called. He wants me to get an old relic while I'm here. The Book of Apologies, which dates back to the 17th century witch trials in Salem. I'll be going to Mosam Castle to retrieve it before I head back to the States. It's said to be haunted, so I'm expecting some good scares and mysteries. Ever yours, Nancy. Ages since I was on my last adventure. So, are you coming in?
That's all right, Miss Drew. I prefer to stay out here.
Why? It's so warm and inviting in here.
Yes, I'm glad you're enjoying yourself. All of Judge Sewell's effects are there, just as your father requested. Although, I will tell you, as I told him, the desk is locked, and I don't have the key. But I will gladly stay and answer any questions you have from the other side of this door. I recommend opening the window for some light. There's no electricity here. Well, in that room, at least.
Oh, much better. What a wonderful view.
Oh, great. You know, that room used to be a prison cell. Mosam Castle was the site of the most famous and violent witch trials in Austrian history. The Salzburg witch trials predate the Salem witch trials by 17 years, actually. After the incidents in Salem, Judge Sewell willed his personal effects to be preserved by whichever museum would have them. And since we are the premier historical reference on witch trials, it ended up here.
So, you've seen his Book of Apologies.
The book written by Judge Sewell? Oh, no. I've never actually been in that room.
You mind if I ask why? Is there something scarier in here than creaky floors?
Well, let's just say that ghosts exist in this castle. And if they do exist,
chains.
They definitely haunt that room.
Ghost? Can't say I've ever seen one, but they are non-corporeal by definition. There really isn't much here.
Yes, Judge Sewell was a Puritan. They believed they should only have purposeful or utilitarian possessions, very little value outside their stated use.
Okay. I haven't messed with this at all, so.
Is this Judge Sewell's desk?
Yes. That desk is where he spent most of his time working when he wasn't in court. Custom made. If the Book of Apologies does exist, he would have written it at that desk.
And what's inside this alleged book?
Your father didn't tell you? It was a ledger containing all the names of the accused witches from the Salem witch trials. Judge Sewell had doubts about his convictions, and he wrote the book as a means to make amends.
Allegedly.
Yes.
Malleus Maleficarum. Wow. The hammer of witches itself. Gives me chills knowing what it did.
Yes, indeed. A how-to guide for hammering out witchcraft. It was written in 1487 by a man whose name I won't even bother to mention because he used bunk science to send hundreds, if not thousands, of people to their deaths.
Off limbs.
They're Dr. Hurst?
Yes, I'm here.
Austria is wonderful.
I do enjoy it here myself. I'm not from Austria. I was brought here by my work. The food is quite an experience.
The pancake soup was great.
Yes, the Frittatensuppe. The locals consider it traditional.
How long have you known my dad?
Oh, Carson and I are not that close. He reached out to me because I'm the historian keeping track of all the relics here. And, as he guessed, we should have the Book of Apologies somewhere.
Lucky I was already here on vacation. I was quite surprised when he called and asked me to come. Though I have to admit, visiting a castle is something I've never been able to turn down.
Do you do these kinds of things a lot?
From time to time. What else can you tell me about the Book of Apologies?
As I mentioned, it's the book written by Judge Samuel Sewell himself, detailing the names of people accused of witchcraft. Sewell was one of the very few judges who regretted his actions. The book became his way of finding redemption. Sewell himself was originally from England, but acted as a judge in the Salem witch trials. Do you perhaps know why Carson would need such a book? Just out of curiosity, of course, it's just such a very unusual request.
He's looking into it as a favor for the current judge in Salem.
Oh.
I'll get back to it.
Take all the time you need.
Some of this stuff looks very old, but it doesn't look like it's very useful. Some of this stuff looks...
Alright, we gotta figure this thing out.
I found a letter. It's addressed to Abigail Hathorne Woodley.
What does it say?
I do regret to write to you in this state. I have been racked with guilt as my fervency of spirit was too great to determine a conviction just. He asks for her forgiveness and for God's.
Why is light capitalized? Anything on the back? Nope. Yeah, light's capitalized for a reason. You push that button.
Locked.
There's a key somewhere.
Very old. Dr. Hurst?
Yes, I'm here.
I'll get back to it.
Take all the time you need.
There really is... Some of this stuff looks... An old chest. Some of this stuff... Hard to tell. They're real...
All right.
Locked.
There we go.
What a clever desk. It even comes with a labyrinth. Easy. I found it. It's here.
What? Really? Amazing.
It's locked behind some sort of cage, though. The lock says... A.W. Any ideas?
A.W.? No. But I have some tools in the shop that might be able to cut it free. In my shop. I'll go. Meet me there.
Where is that? Hey, wait for me. The Book of Apologies. It's locked. Smooth. Stop! Stop running! Figure out which way they went. Must be a clue here.
So they had the key.
A.W. Same as the desk. This canister looks to have been used as a homemade smoke bomb.
All right. They're going to Boston. Via first class. Of course, all that stuff's gone.
A ticket to Boston.
Deirdre. What is it?
You know where I am right now? Salem.
Salem? As in, witch trial Salem?
Obvi. Come on, Drew. My cousin has... Well, she's gotten into some trouble here, and I thought I could help her out. But it turns out this situation is much more complicated than I anticipated. So now, I'm calling you to ask for some... guidance.
You want my help?
Oh, yes. Don't make this more painful. I could use your professional opinion, okay?
Well, it so happens that the case I'm on is connected to Boston, which is just nearby Salem. And I was never a big believer in coincidences.
Oh, are you sure?
I'd love to.
Seriously?
I thought I had reached a dead end, but it looks like I have to go to Massachusetts anyway. In any case, a fresh perspective would do me good.
Ugh, you're already annoying me, and you're not even here yet.
You're welcome. I think it might even be fun.
Oh, this is so the worst idea I've ever had. I'll pick you up from the airport.
I appreciate you coming here, Drew.
I'm just glad you didn't change your mind and leave me at the airport.
Might have crossed my mind. Keep the excessive cheeriness under control, and we'll be fine.
No promises.
Where were you, by the way?
Austria.
Did I interrupt a vacation with Ned?
Didn't you bring me here to help with a case?
Yes, I did. And that's it.
A fire? Was anyone hurt?
Happened in the middle of the night. No one was there, thankfully. The house wasn't completely destroyed, but the person who lived there had to move out.
Just so we're clear, this is my case. I know you're a detective and everything, but this is personal. It's family. Well, extended. And from my father's side. But whatever, that's not the point. It's personal. You take my lead, okay?
Of course.
But?
Well, I have done this a couple of times, Deirdre. And in my experience, we can cover twice as much ground if we work side by side.
I, you know, respect your experience and whatever, but family trumps experience. It's sensitive, and I don't want you messing it up by being too...
Too what?
Too you. You're a question machine. This requires gentle handling. Delicate.
And that's been your approach.
Well, like I say, I need help.
So, can I ask some questions?
Like anyone could stop you.
Why don't we start with your extended family?
They're cousins. The Parrys. P-A-R-R-Y.
Oh, like in fencing.
Yes. Tegan is the older one. Mei is younger. They had a difficult childhood, okay? And now Mei is suspected of committing arson on the most important historic mansion in Salem. And I know it's not true. I know it.
What can you tell me about Mei?
She has a reputation as a troublemaker. Seems like a loner to me. Maybe a bit odd at times. Sometimes she can even sense things before they happen.
Odd how?
I don't know. Troubled teen stuff, difficult time as a kid. Oddest thing is, she won't give an alibi.
That would be seen as suspicious.
That's the problem. Everyone is so suspicious of her. Prejudice, I guess. Because of... Well, you'll see.
Sounds like we should talk to her soon.
Where do you think we're going?
Alright, we're going to call it an episode here. When we come back next time, we'll continue on with the questioning. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And if you did, please do like. Bye.